All right, Ship of Magic, spoiler-free review, here we go. As always, at the top of the review, I'm just going to say my general thoughts, no talk about any components of it. If you just like The Art of Discovery, 4.5 out of 5 stars, really amazing experience. I was engaged pretty much the whole time, like I read the last 230 pages in one day, sort of engaged. Like I was completely captivated and only took me a week, even though it's like 800 pages. Really, really solid, high, epic fantasy. So if that's all you came here for, you can leave. And now let's go into briefly the synopsis. And I'm gonna be very brief because I personally think not knowing a lot was why I really enjoyed it. But we're basically in the Realm of the Elderlings world by Robin Hobbs. This is where the Farseer trilogy takes place. I don't see many connections so far. There was like one slight one, but not one where it would matter if you read this before the Farseer trilogy, in my opinion. And we're basically in this area where it's really run by ship trade. And you have this trader family, and you have pirates, and you have this one area that's like a more capital city. And that's the portion of the world we're in, and we're following a trader family primarily. We're following a pirate, and that's where we go. This also has like magical components of live ships. It's the Live Ship Trader series. So there's this type of wood that can be brought to life and have sentience, essentially. That's all I'll say about that. I don't want to go into the specifics because I really do think it's more fun if you just get to discover it. So that's the synopsis though. And boy, did I not know that I needed like boats in my life. I really enjoyed the whole like boat aspect of this series, like being on different ships, doing different things. I really liked it. But let's talk about what I really loved about this series and what I think will make or break your experience with this series. Full stop, like, and that's the characters, because this is character driven and multiple point of view. Like, I don't know how many point of views there are, but there are several. And for me, that was one of its strengths. But if you aren't connecting to any of these characters or a majority of these characters, you're not gonna care what happens, because the plot is primarily character gets put into this situation. How will they get out of this situation or adjust to the new scene of things? And so if you don't care about following someone through that journey, this is not going to work. But for me, I really liked the characters. And part of it was, for me, they all felt extremely human, which could be really frustrating because they are so human. They make some very bad mistakes and they have flaws. And you get to watch it from this dramatic irony point of view. Like, you get to see all of them and all their thoughts. So you get to know what each of them's inner agendas are and who they are as people. But other characters don't have that, like, inside knowledge. And so you're like, no, don't do that. You cannot do that. That's such a mistake. And that's kind of part of the fun. It makes it such like a higher end drama. It really reminds me of those type of TV shows where you're just like watching these tensions between people, but they don't know what you know. And it was really enjoyable to me. I was engaged in everyone's arcs, even the ones that I didn't really like the people. I will say, like, it actually took me a long time to actually love a character per se. Like, I mostly was just like loving watching these people. I don't think I want to meet any of them. I don't want to be friends with any of these people, really. But I was so invested and I really loved watching all of them grow. Like, so much character development for most of the people. And even the characters that didn't have development, or some people I think have as their least favorite characters, I really liked. And I talk about that in a spoiler vlog that I do have for this book. So I will have that in the cards if you want to know my spoiler thoughts on plot points, on characters. But I really liked the choices she made here. So I think just the large variety of characters I had to follow, because you have characters with very different agendas, very different roles in society. But also, I just had such strong emotional responses. Like, I had, like, such empathy for certain characters. I had such hatred for other characters. I just was emotionally in it. I was there. I was rooting. I was voxering all my friends about all the things happening. I'm like, how could this happen? I cannot believe this. Or I would be predicting like, oh, this is not going to go well. This person is going to be heartbroken and I'm going to be heartbroken. It was just this emotional roller coaster because I was so invested and engaged in the stories of these people. So let's like talk about what that means for plot. Right? Like I said, it's very character driven. There is a plot, but this is also very much like the first book in a series type of book. And I mean that as in like, it's a very similar to me as like Way of Kings in the Stormlight Archive, where it is a book that has an arc that happens. Plot does happen, especially like at the end, and you end at a satisfying point. Like the story does end at a point, but mostly this book felt like a, here, meet these people, get invested in these people, watch these people deal with adversity. And now the next part of the story, or maybe the more real part of the story, will be in the next book. That's how it felt to me as like a fantasy reader. But I don't mind that. This is probably one of my favorite first books in a series in a really long time. Like, it made me really want to pick up Mad Ship. Like, if I wasn't on BookTube and I didn't just like have a TBR like 100 books long, I would have probably picked up the Mad Ship like already. But I feel like being a BookTuber, you like don't think that way anymore. At least I for sure don't. But like, that's what this book did. It made me really want to pick up the next book in the series. But like I said, plot-wise, it's not like a traditional plot narrative where you're going to have this climax and everything like that. It just felt very much like characters, get to know them, they're put into these situations that are very hard and tricky, watch them deal with it. That's like the plot structure in my head as I think about it. Another thing I want to talk about are the themes, because I feel like that's what really elevates this story, because Robin Hobb, the way she gets to pull on my heartstrings is by like relating it to real injustice. It's not just cruel things are happening, it's just like unfair things are happening. And they are very, at least in this book, related to real world things. This story has a lot of patriarchy tones to it. You definitely have female characters who can't do what they want to do because it's a system that is patriarchal. And it's so frustrating to watch, but that also, it's so relatable. And also, there's so much greed and capitalism and corruption that lead these families to make decisions that you know aren't right, you know won't lead them down the right path, but that's just, look at the world, like that's how things are. So the ties to the world in these ways and how connected I was to the characters was a big part of why I think this book is so impressive, because I just don't feel like I normally get that drawn in when I read a fantasy book by those themes. Like, those themes will be there, but I don't feel like they're as tangible. Like, they felt tangible. I was like thinking of situations in my life, in my family members' lives, where I'm like, oh yeah, I remember when that happened to that family member because of this rule we have in our government about this thing. And it's just like, that was so unfair then, and it's still unfair here. And it's just like, but this is fiction. Why do I care so much? And I think it's because she really ties it in to the real world stuff. So that is to say, if you don't want to think about these unjust things, maybe don't pick it up. Like, for me, the first 150 pages, I was like watching a train crash, and not in a good way. I was just like, oh, I know what's going to happen because I know how the world works, but I don't want that to happen. I don't want it. I don't want it. And it was just, that feeling actually felt really bad for a while. I didn't like feeling that emotionally frustrated and angry. But also, I think it's really impressive the book did that. And for me, it did go away and become more of just an emotional investment and less of like this actual like pain that I was feeling. But that's something you should be aware of, because if you want to read a book and not feel that, I totally understand. Like, it's not a pleasant emotion. When people say Robin Hobb will hurt you, they're not kidding. She's very much about the realism of the situation, or I don't know. I don't know who hurt Robin Hobb. I really don't. But if you've read any of her books, or if you're going to, you're going to learn really quickly that she errs on the side of realism over making her characters happy almost every time. There are always stakes, and it's always a lot. Like, a lot. The last thing I'll talk about is the world. I always feel like this is, for me, always the like weaker component of Hobb books. Like, I think the world's nice. I'm really curious about certain aspects of it. But for a large part, I don't care that much about the politics of it. There's not enough magic. I want more magic. Like, there are things that were introduced, and I'm like predicting certain ways they're intertwined that I'm like really excited about. And there's this certain group of people I really want to learn more about, and I think I'm gonna get like a character point of view in there soon, and I'm really excited about it. So I do feel the world is well-grounded, well-formed, and real, but it's not why I pick up this book. This is not a book where, for my world-building sensitivities, because I love world building. I pick up books sometimes just for the world building. That's not what this book is for me. I picked up this book over and over again because I needed to know what would happen next to this character who was put in this situation. Like, I needed to know. It wasn't because I wanted to learn about this world through this interaction sort of thing. And those are my ship of magic thoughts. I had a surprisingly amazing time. I only liked the Farseer trilogy. Like, I thought it was good to great. Like, it was a very well done trilogy. I am so pumped to see what the Live Ship Trader series does for me. It has so many things going for it, and I'm really excited. And if you made it this far and you don't have anything you'd like to add in the comments down below, feel free to leave like an anchor or a ship to let me know you're here. And otherwise, like if you liked it, subscribe if you want to, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.